Kato Philemon, a 12-year-old boy and a son to Muchelli Ronald, was attacked by an elephant on his way to the garden. According to Hannah Tuhera, a district councillor, the deceased was attacked by an elephant which had escaped from National Park to invade farmers' gardens in Nyakatonzi.
Elephants ran after him. The boy tried to run. He was not alone with other colleagues. But of course, he's young. The elephants caught him and smashed him with the ivory. If you can see his head, you can't really imagine that this is a human being. But the biggest problem here is we are not really coordinated with the officials. As leaders, we have talked to them not once, not twice. The chairperson is one, their farmers themselves, the chairman LC3, to really engage all these other stakeholders to bring us some rangers, about 4 or 5, to be guarding. When they shoot in the air, these elephants at times they get away. But it is now almost a year. You can imagine now, people have their cotton, they expect to really harvest in the month of this December or in early January. But of course now, they don't have where to even get this cotton because everything is being destroyed.
Raudia Tumsime, a farmer, says that they are tired of these wild animals which come from the national parks to destroy their crops. She further blames their leaders who have not helped in advocating for tight restrictions of these animals.
Government take a take ho, baradiso to take a take ho, kari watibaru komecha wachikahwa.
Stephen Mbera, the chairperson LC3 for Nyakatonzi sub-county, said that from Nyamgashani up to Wanika, almost 15 kilometers, there is no ranger post to block these animals from crossing.
We have been crying. We have met those guys in several meetings. They are promising us that they are bringing rangers. We wonder. A season is coming to an end. People's foods have been destroyed. Crops have been destroyed. Now human life is being destroyed. Totally, there is no deployment. And when they tell us, they are saying they have no forces. And I ask myself, if they have no forces, what kind of institution is that? They need to look for forces, deploy here, and make sure that they are doing what they're supposed to do, other than just keeping quiet, as if it's too much to my concern.
If you managed as a member of parliament to make laws that if someone is caught in the national park, should be arrested, life imprisonment, why don't you also consider the people that give you votes? We are the citizens of this Uganda. We are all equal and we have our rights and we need to exercise our democracy. Don't keep intimidating us. We have threats of animals in the community. Why? No compensation. And for your information, if every MP of this Kasese area is listening, the children of the farmers that practice under crop husbandry, they no longer go to school.
By press time, Uganda Wildlife Authority had not commented on the incident despite numerous calls by our reporter. Story by Gilbert Muhanguzi for the news in Kasese.